Well, hey there. It's a great morning. It quit raining finally. So that's always a plus if you don't have to run in rain, snow, sleet, or ice. I'm not a damn mailman. We're here. We're gonna get loaded up this morning. While we're sitting here getting loaded up, I got a little bit of time, so I'm going to buzz over the truck with some window cleaner, get those windows cleaned up, get those mirrors cleaned up, because hey, I like looking through clean stuff when I'm driving. This place I'm at right now, they treat you good. They get you in, they get you out, and if you need to, they let you park out there. I always like places like that. It's always a plus when you can find a place that lets you park. Because let's face it, I don't like truck stops. Truck stops annoy me. It's not so much the truck stop, it's just the fact that they're just tight, they're loud, they're annoying, and you gotta put up with a lot of people that I don't want to deal with. So let's get started, let's get these windows cleaned up. We're gonna jump around, run around, thump the tires up, make sure they're all good. Probably should check some fluid in this big beast, but I think we should be all right. Last time I checked, it was pretty good. Didn't suck up any fuel. When I say fuel, I meant oil. It doesn't suck up any oil. It sucks up a lot of fuel. Well, let's get this truck all checked out, make sure we're ready for the road. Hey, I'm just gonna throw this little reminder out there. If you guys like what you see, go ahead and throw a like underneath that little thumbs up part, you know, that part right there. Throw it under there at the end of the video. And I tell you what, give me a shot here and go ahead and subscribe to the channel and we'll see what happens. I'm new at it. I think it'll get better. I got a fancy mic now, so that's got to be a little bit better. Yeah, what we're going to do here is we're just going to check the motor out. We're going to give her a little look-see. Make sure everything's kosher there. Check the oil, check the antifreeze, little stuff. You're not going to dig too deep. I guess they call this the pre-trip. We're going to run around, thump tires up, and see how everything's looking. We did get it loaded up. Now all we got to do is head home. Or I guess not home. We're not heading home, not yet. It's the beginning part of the week yet. We're going to head to Lamar's, Iowa with this load via Chicago. So let's hope traffic is light. All right, we're just going to pull a dipstick out here and give her a little look-see. Got oil on my hands. I'm a truck driver. I'm not supposed to get dirty. Oh, hey, dummy. Use a towel then next time, right? We're a little low on oil. That's to be expected. I'm about 1,000 miles over on an oil change, and I need to get her serviced up. Uh-oh. Kinda looks like we got some antifreeze leaking up here. Better check that out. I swear to God I check my fluids on a normal basis, but we're a little low on antifreeze. I'm thinking the cap is bad. Letting too much through there. Maybe the... What's it called? The relief pressure pounds. I think maybe it might be getting a little... The spring might be getting a little weak. Oil's a little low, but like I said, we're about 1,000 miles over on an oil change. I change her about every 12 to 15,000 miles, and we're probably sitting around 16,000 miles on it now. And after that 15,000 mile mark, she starts to use a little bit of oil. Nothing huge, but it uses a little bit. It's to be expected. The motor works hard. We gave everything a real good thorough look over on this side, and everything seemed to be okay, so I think we're just going to go ahead and close the hood up and check those tires out and get the show on the road. You know when you go by a truck stop and you see those guys running around? Big hammers, little bats. They're thumping their tires and you're thinking to themselves, how in the world do they know how much air is in the tire by hitting it? We don't. This time of year, it's easier to just give them a good smack. Make sure they're not flat. And after doing it enough times, you know that you kind of know if it's a little low. Now, if it was warmer out, probably about once a week when it's warm out, when I'm home during the weekend. I'll put the gauge on the truck tires. But I don't want to do it now. So we know they're good. We know they're up. Alright, everything's done with the truck. Now I'm thinking it's time to go do some trucking, and let's hope that the traffic isn't too much going through Chicago, right? Alright? Alright, let's go. Just fine. That city's a hit and a miss. You never know what it's going to be doing. A lot of people are always complaining about the traffic there. And you know, technically, when I say made it through Chicago, we didn't go through Chicago. We took 80 on the south side of Chicago. But a lot of people complain about that stretch. I've gone through there a lot. I don't know if it's just because they've driven that way their entire life or whatnot, but technically, they're not that bad. I mean, they might jump four or five lanes in one stretch. By they, I'm talking about cars. They might just jump, you know, four or five lanes in one stretch. But I can probably count on one hand how many times I've been cut off by an actual car going through Chicago. Now, trucks, that's different. So I really don't mind going through there. You know, I've been through there in the middle of the night, middle of the day, mornings, rush hour, the whole works. And it seems to go okay with me. But I'm not going to be taping any footage out the front windshield going through Chicago. So I tell you what, that's rough. Those roads, whew, they're not getting any better. I tried taping some out the windshield. Let's just say that didn't go good. Yeah, I want to talk about phone calls a little bit. How many, or not really how many, but how many people do you talk to during the day when you're in your truck, car, or work? That's guaranteed people that you're going to talk to every day. And how long is the longest phone conversation you've ever had? But I'll tell you what, I have 3 guaranteed calls that I'm going to get a day. Either get or I'm going to make. And they're simple calls, you know. Mama Schmidt, I tell you what, every single day like clockwork, she's going to call me. Yeah, I'm a mama's boy. Get over it. But I got another buddy of mine. I call him California. We can talk to each other for a long time on the phone. I'm going to tell you the time, and you're going to say, what? I think the longest conversation we've ever had on the phone was probably 12 hours. And right now you're thinking, how in the hell do you talk on the phone for 12 hours? What do you talk about? I can truthfully tell you, I don't know. There's things we talk about that I sure shit am not going to put on the YouTube waves, as you say. But then there's things we talk about. We're talking about trucks, cars. We're talking about home life. We're talking about a little bit about the weather, you know, stuff like that. We can talk for a long time. And I tell you what, time like that, it helps the day go by so much faster. And there's days where he's parked, he's at home, or I'm parked, I'm at home. Then we usually don't chit-chat. It's usually in the truck. He doesn't live too far from me. We'll go chase each other down every once in a while. But then I got another old-timer that I call him. He's been in the trucking world for probably 50 years. I think he's coming up on 50 years now. We've been trucking together for a long time. We actually pull the same company's trailers. But before that, back when I used to run local and I ran distilled grain back and forth from Iowa to Nebraska, we did that together. And he is, yeah, we'll probably talk two or three times a day when we're both out on the road. And they're not long conversations. They're probably about 10, 15 minutes or so. I call him Roustabout. And the knowledge in that man's head scares me when it comes to trucking. But he's a veteran. He's been doing this for, like I said, 50 years. So right there's three. You know, you got Mama Schmidt, you got California, and you got Roustabout. And then towards the evening, towards the end of the evening, and it's not every night, Mrs. Schmidt, she's not a big phone person, which is fine. You know, I think the longest conversation I've had with my own wife on the phone is probably, I think I had her on the phone for 30 minutes once. Those were records. I mean, I was posting pictures on Facebook about it. You know, those were records that were set. But it's usually a check call, you know. We're talking to each other, hey honey, how's it going? How was your day? How was your day? How's the kids? Type thing. Now there's days that go by and I don't get any calls and I start thinking, is my phone broke? Is there something wrong with it? But in the comments, I want you to tell me how many calls a day you might get going down the road in the truck or in the car or while you're sitting at the house. What's the longest call you've ever had? Let me know down in the comments there. Just me again. Guess what? I'm still fighting. I'm fighting with a microphone. Beginning to think maybe it might be my phone. I don't know. We're stopping to Best Buy or something to see what's going on. So right now, no microphone. Worry about it when we're outside if it's windy or not. We're about 350 miles till we get to Lamar's, Iowa. Should be there roughly around 1:30, 2 o'clock in the morning. I had to stop by Walcott. Walcott is the world's biggest truck stop. And I know earlier I said I hate truck stops, and then I decided to stop by the world's big one. Go figure. They got a Blimpies. Next. It's the best Blimpies you've ever had. No, that's not why I stopped. I have a little cousin, her little girl, has a birthday coming up, and my grandma asked if I could stop at a truck stop or somewhere if I seen a little unicorn to pick her up one for her birthday. And it'd be my grandma's great-granddaughter. So I figured, yeah, we can stop by. Truck stops, as we all know, have basically everything, especially little knickknacks. So I stopped by here in Walcott, and I found that. I think she will be happy. At least I'm hoping she will be happy. You gotta keep grandma happy. You gotta keep the wife happy. You gotta keep mama happy. You gotta keep grandma happy. It's all just a game of keeping everybody happy. Well, I'm a little frustrated about the mic still. So, I'm going to get off here. We're going to get some trucking done. I'll get back to you probably when we get back into Lamar's there. That's probably where we're going to call home for the night. All right. See you in a little bit.